A once historic gem on Long Island's South Shore is being picked apart and damaged by vandals. Residents near the former Dowling College say once the school went belly up, historic buildings are not being protected by the new owners. Here's CBS2's Carolyn Gusoff from Oakdale.
Every night, Oakdale residents walk this sprawling land that was once Dowling College. And almost every night, they say they discover and repair heartbreaking vandalism.
It's disheartening. I feel like I'm going to cry. The damage inside is beyond what you could imagine.
Built in 1901, this 110-room mansion was a Long Island treasure, the summer estate of William Vanderbilt, named Idlehour. Years later, it became Dowling College, which went bankrupt, and since then...
It's sad. You know, every night when we walk, when there's more damage, there's more destruction, more vandalism.
The 25 waterfront acres were sold to Mercury International, a Hong Kong-based company that agreed to protect historic buildings.
The Historical Society is appalled at the damage to our history, the woodworking that is 100 years old, stained glass, things that cannot be replaced.
Copper gutters stolen, treasured interiors ransacked, fountains trashed, weeds so unsightly residents mow themselves.
We have found hammers around the property that they have thrown through windows, that they have broken off doors.
They're like a delinquent landlord. It's horrible that they're allowing this to happen.
Town of Islip Supervisor Angie Carpenter says she's also frustrated by the private company.
They're in China, you know, so it's very difficult. We have been writing violations left and right.
The town's demanding Mercury install security cameras or pay to have the town install them. Our request for comment went unanswered.
They should be responsible as we're responsible as private homeowners to maintain their property.
When Mercury bought this property, the company promised to maintain a jewel of the community. Residents say they still don't know what's planned for this land, but they say they do know that promise wasn't kept. In Oakdale, Long Island, Carolyn Gusoff, CBS 2 News.